Now we see here to make a chemical equation more informative. First, physical state. Physical state of reactants and products are mentioned in the small bracket as S, L, G, AQ, ALC, etc. We use S for solid state and L for liquid, such that for water we use L. For gaseous substances we use G in a small bracket to represent the physical state of the substance in a chemical equation. AQ represent for the aqueous solution. Aqueous solution means the solution made in water, and the water acts as a solvent. Then we use AQ, such that the solution of NaCl in water is represented as NaClAQ, ZnSO4 as ZnSO4AQ, H2SO4AQ, HClAQ. These all are made in water, means these substances dissolve in water to make aqueous solution of these. ZnSO4 represent aqueous solution of ZnSO4. ALC represent alcoholic solution. If we use alcohol instead of water, then we use ALC in bracket after the formula in the chemical equation. With an example, we cleared it. Magnesium is in solid state at room temperature, so we use S after the symbol of Mg. HCl is dissolved in water to form aqueous solution of HCl, so we use AQ in the bracket. Magnesium chloride is formed after the chemical reaction. This is in the form of aqueous solution, or present in the form of aqueous solution in the product side, so we use AQ in the bracket. And hydrogen evolved during this reaction, so we use G, because hydrogen is gas. Or also we can use other sign like this up arrow. This arrow represent the gaseous substance. Second point, concentration of the reactants and products. We use CONC, conc, for concentrated solution. Concentrated means gadha, and DIL, dilute. Dilute means tanu or patla. We look here, we see here for difference between conc and dilute. See here, there are two beakers in which both have same water, 100 ml, and in first beaker we add 50 gram sugar and in second beaker 80 gram of sugar. So we say that this solution has more solvent, so this is concentrated than this one. Means we can say that a solution having more solvent solute than the other solution, then first is the concentrated and the second one is dilute solution. In first reaction, zinc reacts with hydrochloric acid to form zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. In this reaction we use dilute hydrochloric acid. But in the second reaction, copper reacts with conc H2HNO3 nitric acid to form copper nitrate, water and NO2. So we see here, highly reactive metals react with dilute acid and less reactive metal reacts with conc acid. We clearly or deeply read after this chapter in acid base and salt. Now we see here, concentration of reactants and products are represented by dilute and conc for acid or base. Next point is reaction condition. The condition of reaction is written on the arrow. Here iron, molybdenum 723 Kelvin, 280 m, These are condition for this reaction. Nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen gas to form ammonia. This reaction is under the catalyst of iron and promoter of molybdenum at 723 Kelvin temperature and about 200 atm pressure. These are the condition of reaction. This information make equation more informative. By this we make a chemical equation more informative. Next, for heat change. There are two types of chemical reaction according to heat change. First and second. First is endothermic chemical reaction and endothermic chemical reaction. And second is exothermic chemical reaction. Endothermic chemical reaction means the reaction in which heat is required. The reaction in which heat is required is called endothermic chemical reaction. And the reaction in which heat is produced is called exothermic chemical reaction. Means a reaction in which heat is given out or heat is evolved is called exothermic. For this we use the sign of plus heat and minus heat in the product side. When heat is evolved, then we add plus heat in the product side. For example, coal is burned in the air, then heat is produced with carbon dioxide, then C plus O2 CO2 plus heat. And when heat is absorbed in the chemical reaction, then we use here minus sign for endothermic reaction, and for exothermic reaction we use plus heat, plus sign, and with heat for exothermic chemical reaction. Now, fifth point is nature of reaction. There are two types of chemical reaction. First is reversible and second one is irreversible. For reversible reaction, we use this type of sign between the reactants and products. And for irreversible reaction, we use a straight arrow or arrow sign between reactants and products. This represent reversible chemical reaction and this one represent irreversible chemical reaction. Here N2O4 gas is in gaseous state, NO2 also in gaseous state. First half arrow represent forward reaction and down arrow, backward arrow represent downward reaction or backward reaction. This arrow represent forward reaction and this arrow represent backward reaction. And a lot of examples we write in the previous classes and up till now. Another example is here. Mg plus HCl, MgCl2 plus H2. This is irreversible reaction. Another definition of reversible and irreversible reactions are here. When reactants react together, each other to form product, but product do not react each other to form the reactants, then the reaction is irreversible. But in reversible reaction, reactants reacts to form product and product again reform the reactants. This type of reaction is reversible. According to physical change, you clearly understand. Here is ice and ice melts to form water, and then we heat ice, B obtained water, and when water is cold, cool, then ice is formed. Here ice to water and water to ice is a chemical, a physical change, and this is reversible physical change. This is reversible. But when we burn wood and obtained product, but after some time we do not reform the reactant, this is permanent and irreversible change. And last is a speed of the reaction. Sixth point is speed of reaction. There are two types of reaction on the basis of a speed. Sixth is a speed of reaction. According to a speed, we divide a chemical reaction in two types. First is slow reaction and second is fast reaction. The reaction between metal and acid, reaction between acid and base are fast reaction, and this reaction take very little time to completion, but slow reaction take more time for completion. Generally reversible reactions are slow and irreversible reactions are fast, and we mention slow or fast information on the arrow. For example, Mg plus HCl arrow fast, MgCl2 plus H2 guys, aqueous solid. This, by this we make chemical equations more informative. In examination question is, how can you make a chemical equations more informative? Then you write in your copy and remember these all 6 points and make a notes for future.